What's up, what's up, what's up? That was an awesome performance from the Acielo duo. And that's exactly how we do it on Artistic Tuesdays. And moving on, I'm joined by a paintbrush artist. Mm-hmm. You want to talk to the people?
Okay. My name is Joshua Karoli.
Okay.
But I'm well known as Karoli Arts. Yes. I'm a portrait artist based in Nairobi.
Okay. So I see you actually came with your stuff here today.
Yeah, I had to bring some samples. You know, people can't believe unless they see.
Okay, let me see some of it. What do we have here? Can you explain this?
Yeah, this piece is called Serenity.
Okay.
Serenity, I call it that. Because if you look at the woman, she's at peace. She's meditating. So, and when you're meditating, you have to be in peace in order to meditate. So this woman was meditating, that's why she was washing her face.
Okay.
So I decided to call the piece Serenity.
So she's not crying?
No, she's not. This is water.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So I'm going to ask you a few questions regarding this specific piece that I'm holding.
Mm-hmm.
So, one, is this, would you call this fine art?
Yes, this is fine art, though I've not, it's inborn. I've not studied about art anywhere. I just had a mentor.
Oh.
Yeah.
So you didn't actually go to school?
I went to school, but I didn't go to study about art.
Okay.
Yeah.
So when exactly did you actually figure out you can be an artist?
Long time ago, when I was very little. Mm-hmm. You know, in primary school, we used to do a lot of cartoons. That's when I knew I had the talent of drawing. My dad used to support me. My mom always supported me. Then in high school,
mm-hmm.
the subjects I chose, biology, had a lot of drawing. So there even the teachers noticed my skills.
Okay.
Then just before I finished, I met a guy called Nelly. He's my mentor. Mm-hmm. He taught me a bit. Then that's how I came.
Okay.
Yeah.
So would you tell us where you actually draw your inspiration from?
Okay, most of my inspiration are from my mentor, Nelly Mchoraji.
Yeah.
I want to reach in his level.
Okay.
Although I've started late last year to do it professionally, but mm-hmm. I'm going somewhere.
So, I mean, you're telling me you actually figured out you can be an artist a long time ago.
Yeah.
And definitely you've gone through some challenges.
Yes.
How has the test been for you?
The test, it has been tough. Sometimes you can do a piece, then upload it in the internet and people say, this is Photoshop. We know these guys, this is an editor, this is not something drawn by hand. Sometimes to convince somebody that this is legit art is a bit tricky. Then if you get a client, maybe he or she wants the artwork within 2 days. You know, art is something that takes time. You can't do it within 2 days and be complete. That's another challenge.
Okay.
Because you have to have enough time to do quality work.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And since you began painting, mm-hmm. what are some of the major paintings that you've ever done? And let's say maybe the biggest sale that you ever made.
The biggest sale, I drew Sakaja, the Honorable Sakaja, the MP.
When he was a spokesman or when he's...
Last year. Okay. It was last year.
Okay.
Okay, the piece was bought by somebody at 5,000. So, and it was just a small piece.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, people actually buy politicians' paintings.
Mm-hmm.
That's quite interesting.
Yeah.
So I want to ask you, there's a guy out there who is young, like maybe the way you were when you actually discovered painting,
mm-hmm.
who wants to be an artist. What would you tell that guy?
I'll tell that guy, if you're good at something, maybe not necessarily art, even football or anything, just talent, don't let it go. Use it to the fullest. As in, like, when I started drawing, people used to tell me that this talent won't take you anywhere. It's just a part, let's say it's just a hobby. But I used to draw consistently, uploading it in the internet, then I got noticed. So if you're out there, you have the talent, don't put it down. Show it to the world. Wonders might happen.
Let's go back to this specific painting that you call Serenity.
Mm-hmm.
How long does it take to make this painting?
This took 4 days.
Including the framing and everything?
Yeah, framing is just 1 day, but the painting itself took 4 days.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, can you take me through the stages of making this painting?
Okay, first you start with the sketch.
Okay.
After the sketch, you start shading bit by bit, putting the eyelashes, the hair, the water, then detailing
okay.
the reflections, the shades. Then you finish by applying the background, mm-hmm. mounting it, and framing.
Wow. Yeah. So how much would you sell this specific piece for?
This will go for 7,000.
7,000?
Yeah.
And it's value for money?
Yes, it is.
Would you say it's worth your work?
Yes, it is worth.
Okay, it's beautiful. I get to understand that there are usually festivals for painters and arts.
Yeah.
Have you attended any festivals yet?
No, not yet, but I have plans for exhibition, competitions, and festivals.
Okay.
Yeah.
So there's this question I've always wanted to ask anybody who's taking talent as a career. Mm-hmm. Well, I can remember I was beat up so many times as a young kid because I couldn't go to class. I wanted to play. Mm-hmm. So how did you get to convince your parents that, you know what, I want to be a painter? Because, you know, we're all Africans and African parents. They believe more in school than talent.
Yeah. When I was in high school, my dad wanted me to be a lawyer. Mm. So, but he knew I had the talent. So he used to support me in the talent then in academy works. But he told me, first, finish your school, then you'll start doing whatever you want. But in the meantime, you have to learn. So I had a timetable. I could read from Monday to Friday, then on weekends I could do some artworks.
Okay.
And he used to support me. So personally, I thank my dad because he supported me all the way.
Yeah, that's a good point. I hope you can hear that. Parents, talent actually pays. So I want to ask you, you've probably showcased your stuff out there.
Yeah.
Could you tell us how the feedback is? Is it positive? How are people actually relating? And maybe the major festivals that you've actually showcased in?
Okay, the first time when I showcased them was just in our area, that estate.
Okay.
A place called Social Hall. I took some of my artworks there. People are like, wow, this is amazing. But others were like, no big deals, just art.
Definitely haters.
So, yeah. People don't know that. The other people don't know the value of art, but others do. So after the showcasing, when I went back home, I got some orders. I advertised myself well that day. From then, I got a few orders. People started knowing me as a portrait artist. Others even marketed me.
Okay.
Yeah.
So in every business, there's always the low season.
Yeah.
You know those times when people don't have money, mm-hmm. when people are not buying your paintings.
Yeah.
How do you keep up with life?
As a portrait artist, I don't have months like those. I only have good months like on February before Valentine's. Everybody wants to be drawn.
Yeah.
This festive season, most people want to be drawn. The other months, I can get maybe 4 to 5 orders a month.
So you want to tell me you never get a point where you are actually broke?
No.
Whoa, I should be a painter. That makes everything very easy.
Yeah.
Would you stand up and actually say art actually pays?
Yes, I would. As for me, my artworks, per week I can get 3 to 4 orders. And per order is 3,000, so yes, it does pay. And it pays my bills, it clothes me, and it feeds me. So art pays.
And this is the job you want to do until you grow old. You want to raise your kids, have a family.
Yeah, I do arts full time, 24/7.
If you had a kid today.
I do.
Oh, you have a kid?
Yeah.
Daughter or son?
Daughter.
How old is she?
1 year.
1 year.
Yeah.
So what's the name of your daughter?
Favor.
Favor.
Yeah.
So when Favor grows up and she decides she wants to be an artist, would you give her the exact support that you got from your dad?
Full support.
Yes.
From the colors, the papers, everything. I will support her 100%.
Where do you see the future of art in Kenya going, or Africa in general?
Okay, most people know paintings, but for me, I do pencil work. When I started doing the artworks, people started noticing that not only paints can be artworks, but also pencils and pen work.
Okay.
So years to come, I've even seen that they've started importing like the kneadable eraser, which was not in Kenya previously.
Yeah.
So we also have art fairs, which supports our talent. So in years to come, art will be something really big, not as it is today.
You have a few gadgets here on the table.
Yeah.
And I want to believe these are some of the materials that you use.
Mm-hmm.
Can you take us through this?
Yeah, I can. Like here,
so those are your pencils.
These are my pencils which I use. This is called a 7B.
Okay.
I use it on the hair, sometimes on the eyes and lips because it's dark, that mm-hmm. darkness. Then this is a 6B. I use mm-hmm. it on skin tone, the lights and the darkness, the skin tone itself.
So it has a different shade from the other one?
Yeah, it does.
Okay.
Then this is the kneadable eraser.
This is the one you were saying yeah. is being imported now.
Yeah, it's like a modeling, but it's an eraser.
So what's different from the erasers that we all know?
This you can shape and rub a small part, but the others are just something big, hard, you can't shape it. Okay. But let's say I want to put a reflection in the eye. I'll just shape it into something like this, shade that part, and it will be reflective.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what's this?
That's an eraser.
Looks like a sharpener?
Yeah, it is a sharpener, not an eraser.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let me ask you, how much do your instruments actually cost?
Okay, the expensive thing that I can say is these pencils, because they are still being imported.
Yeah.
They are not available here, but a box goes for 1,000 bob, so it's not that expensive, but this goes for 50 shillings. These are just cheap things, but the product out of them, it's amazing what they produce.
So, when we go for shopping, I mean, we see pencils every day.
Mm-hmm.
What's the difference between these pencils and the normal pencils that we see in the shop?
Like, if you see this pencil, the graphite, it's a bit thick.
Than I think the ones, you need to explain yeah, graphite.
Graphite, this is the charcoal in it
okay.
that is used for drawing. This graphite is thicker than the one people use in school, even if you check out this one. So these are used for art, specifically art. You can't write notes in them or do something else, just art. Yeah.
How do you choose what you're gonna paint?
Mostly I get orders, but when I'm free, I Google some African pictures, African themes, and I do them.
So let's get back to challenges.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? What I understand about art is that sometimes you need to access a showroom for you to be able to sell your art. Because there's always that guy in your neighborhood who would want your art, but yeah. would want to buy them at Biyamta. Mm. And you also want to expose your art to guys out there who can actually pay value for money.
Yeah.
So how do you actually market your stuff?
Mostly I market my stuff in the internet, Facebook, the whole social media.
Mm-hmm.
I post my artworks there, the price, and how they can contact me and how they can place their orders. Then around our hood, I have a bit of friends who always go telling around that I know somebody who can draw you exactly you are, how you are. I know somebody that can do an amazing portrait. But, oh yeah, you did say that there are people who want some discount. Okay, for a discount, I don't really tolerate that because this is business. And for a discount in a business, it might bring some loss.
Mm-hmm.
So that's just it.
So, ukakuwa na bestie yako mtaani, he really likes your art. And you know his hustle. You know this is how much he has and how much he can get. And he comes to you and he tells you, Joshua, I know you're in a hustle as well, but manze hii painting yako imenibamba mbaya. You cannot give an excuse for that.
I can.
You can?
That one I can.
So have you done it before?
Yes, I have done a couple of times, maybe thrice.
So do they market you or you just do it because unaleta ubesi take a job?
They do market me. Like one I sold to my friend.
Uh-huh.
After some few months, he brought me 2 clients.
Hmm, that's how business works.
Mm-hmm.
So have you been to any showroom? Like have you taken your pieces to any showroom?
Only in estate, not out.
And how did that go?
It went pretty well because people appreciated my artwork. People took my number, they contacted me, and I made them beautiful pieces. So it really boosted my business.
Okay.
Yeah.
So when you do celebrity pictures,
mm-hmm.
you know, intellectual property, do you have the rights to do that?
Yes, I
do. Rather, you get the rights to do that because, you see, if you were to draw my painting today, I could actually come and complain. Because you're going to sell it and make money off my picture.
Okay, most portraits that I do for celebrities are my own property. I don't sell them out, not unless you have contacts with that guy and you want to take it to him and I have to confirm. But if you just want to buy it to put it in your house, I cannot accept that. Like I've done most celebrities, but I've hung them on my wall. They are not for sale.
I really understand that you appreciate art. Mm-hmm. And we appreciate young people like you who are actually taking a different direction in life. Like we do not always have to make it through books.
Yeah.
And trust me, I give you kudos for that.
Thanks.
Okay, it was really nice to have you on the show.
Mm-hmm.
And I wish you well in all your job.
Thank you.
And I want you to tell the viewers before you leave, how can they find you?
Okay, you can find me on my social media page, Facebook, Caroli Arts, Instagram at Caroli_Arts, and in Twitter, Caroli Arts.
Well, folks, that was Joshua Okech on Paintbrush. And after the break, we're going to have Aisha on photography.